Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another Android app development tutorial. Today we are going to talk about another OneSignal event, that is background notification received event. As it named, it will work even when our app is not in the foreground state. As we have seen in the last video that the foreground notification received event was useful for retrieving data from the notifications, but our app needs to stay in the foreground state. Whereas using this background notification received event, we'll be able to retrieve data at any time whenever we receive notifications. We can even update our UI immediately from this background notification received event when our app is in the foreground state. And for that, we'll be implementing a broadcast receiver. So just stay tuned till the end, because this is gonna be a step-by-step process. And by the time when you complete watching this video, you can hit the like button and leave your comments, because that's the only way to communicate with each other. Anyway, guys, let's get started. As you guys can see, I have opened up our last project, and these are the things we have already discussed. So if you haven't watched our previous two videos, and if you have directly jumped into this video, then my suggestion would be just watch those videos, or at least the part one, where you will learn the way to set up the OneSignal SDK in the Android Studio project. Now if you have done so, great. Now you can understand what I'm gonna do here. So first and foremost, I'll comment this foreground event handler, because we are going to implement the background notification received event as an alternative of the foreground notification received event. And this is also somehow pretty easy. So to begin with, let's create a Java class. Right click, new Java class. Let's name it notification service. Now here simply call implements, then OneSignal dot OS remote notification received handler. This is what our background received event is. Now let's fix this error just by implementing a method called remote notification received. No more warnings. Perfect. Now before I explain to you this remote notification received method, let's include this service class in the manifest. Now inside this application tag, we need to set a metadata. Simply type angle bracket metadata name. It's a constant value, so just do what I'm doing. Com dot OneSignal dot notification service extension. Now add value attribute. Here we need to pass the exact path of this notification service class. So I'll just copy this package. Paste here, then dot, type the class name, in this case notification service, and that's it for initialization. Now let's understand this remote notification received method, how we should deal with the notification data, because from now, whenever a new notification arrives, this function will be called. So this method is providing context and OS notification received event. Here we will focus on this object. Although in the last video we have seen how we should retrieve data from this object. However, I'm gonna repeat the same stuff again for you. So let's create an instance of the OS notification class. Equal to call this OS notification received event, then dot get notification. Now in order to retrieve data such as title, description, we can call notification.getTitle or notification.getBody. Let's print these values in the logcat. Log E notification.getTitle. Now press Ctrl D, duplicate line. Let's change this to get body. Finally, in the end, let's call voice notification received event dot complete. Then simply pass this notification object. Perfect. Okay, now I'm gonna build and run this code on my Android device so that next time I send a push notification, this remote notification received method should work. Let's check this out. As you can see, our app is running now. Let's open Logcat. Then filter it by the tag. Also, I'm going to close this app. Now the app is neither in the foreground state nor in the background state. It is completely killed, right? Now if I send a push notification, will you see the title and the description in the logcat? Let's see. Click on messages, new message, new push. Now I'll set a title, then a description or message. Let's scroll down, click review and send. Then send message. See in the logcat, here is the title and the description. Also, if I show you my device, see, here is the notification. So yes, we can say our notification service is working properly. Now let's talk a little bit about the additional data, because most of the time, if you are making an app like e-commerce app, then you not just need to show the title and description. Instead, you might also need some additional fields such as product name, image, price. It could be any kind of information, and you may need to show those data in your notification. So let's see how do we retrieve those additional fields here. So let's create a JSON object first. JSON object equal to notification dot get additional data. Now if your additional field name is like product name or string type data, then simply call this JSON object, then dot get string, then double quotes and pass your field name, for example product underscore name. So this is how you should retrieve each individual field from a JSON object. And like this get string, you can even call get JSON object. If you have an object inside an object, then you can use this. Also, we have get JSON array. If your JSON object contains an array, then get boolean, double, int. So the fact of the matter is you need to choose the right get method according to your data type. Finally, remember to surround this line with try catch block. Otherwise, it will throw a JSON exception. Now let's store this in a string variable. Product name. Now if you have an image URL, then simply pass the field name. For example, product underscore image. Then store in a variable. Simple. But usually I prefer to create a model class, then store this data. Therefore, all the notification data will be organized at one place. Anyway, now again I'm going to print these values in the logcat. log E, then here plus product name. Let's duplicate the line. Here I will pass the product image. Alright, now I'm going to build and run this code in my Android device again, just to test it. Now I will add these fields in the additional data section. So let's open the OneSignal website. Click new message, new post. Set a title, additional test. Then set a message, testing notification. Now in this advanced settings, click here. See, we have an additional data section. So our first field is product name. Let's copy it, paste here, and set a value. Acer laptop X2. Let's add another field, that is product image. So here we can set an image URL of our product. Finally, we can now send this notification. Let's click review and send, then send message. Yes guys, I've received a notification. See. Also in the logcat, see, we received both the data, product name and product image. So like this notification title and description, we can set this data over here by simply replacing our default notification UI, and that will be explained in a separate video. However, in the next video, I'm gonna show you how we can update the UI immediately when our app is in the foreground state. And for that, I'll be using the broadcast receiver component. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.